Judge Eileen Cannon, the Trump-appointed judge that, of course, is overseeing the documents trial down in South Florida, granted Donald Trump yet another undeserved victory this past week when she agreed to pretty much suspend all of the deadlines that she herself had set because Donald Trump's lawyers have just told her, golly gee, we just can't seem to get that secure facility built so that we can, you know, let our client view the classified documents. You know, because the defense says, you said he can't take them to Mar-a-Lago, and we didn't get a facility ready while we were waiting for that decision from you, so yeah, it's on us, but could you do us a solid and just get rid of all those deadlines like the October one you had set for us to actually have the facility built? And Judge Cannon, even though it was 100% Donald Trump's lawyer's screw-up, said, sure, why not? None of my deadlines matter, even though I gave you back in July specific instructions to do this thing. You didn't do it, but I'll just give you more time anyway. Now, all of this, by the way, is actually part of a broader motion filed by Donald Trump's lawyers to get the whole trial delayed from May of next year until sometime after the 2024 election, at which point, if Trump were to win, he would simply pardon himself and the whole damn thing would go away in the first place, which is exactly what he is hoping happens here. And given the fact that the judge has now gotten rid of all the deadlines, Trump's lawyers don't have a deadline to meet. Oh, maybe we'll get the facility secured in a month. Maybe it'll be 6 months. Who knows? But this decision by Judge Cannon is absolutely just handing a massive victory to Donald Trump for no other reason than clearly Cannon still has loyalty to Donald Trump. That's what this is about. She told the lawyers in July, you got 3 months to get this facility set up. They filed a motion, of course, to just let him, you know, asking the judge, can he just take him to Mar-a-Lago? She recently said, no, he can't. So now they're like, okay, but, you know, while we were waiting for that decision, we just didn't do the thing we were ordered to do, even though our motion would not have impacted our ability to do that. So the judge says, ah, forget it. This is mind-blowing to me. It's mind-blowing to me how Jack Smith and the DOJ have not already filed a motion to get this judge off the case. Because you look at all of these other trials happening with Donald Trump, and there's a lot of them. Trump's losing motion after motion after motion after motion because judges are tossing him out because, hey, this is a dumb argument. Judge Chutkan with the January 6th trial. Trump's lawyer said, oh, hey, we're not going to meet the deadline that you gave us to get our classified security clearance so we can look at the documents. And she said, oh, well, that's on you. I gave you plenty of time. You should have done it. Cannon goes the opposite route. Oh, it's okay, guys. I know you meant well. Take all the time you need. There's no deadlines anymore. You just make sure that you have our little guy secured so that we can, you know, continue to coddle him and make sure that he doesn't get convicted. Because at the end of the day, that's what this ruling is all about. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.